audience. His audience of one, maybe, in Esterhazer. The prince. Would you want to come to the concert tonight, darling? There might have been two. Maybe a friend was staying. There really were 70 bedrooms. But the prince was very keen on music. This was played, this was written for and played in Esterhazer. I don't know if anybody's been there, but it's a wonderful, beautiful castle which was built while Haydn was working for the Esterhazer. The second movement, which is marked Andante, but it's in 3-8, which means it's really quite fast, I think. And we'll try and play it even faster than we did this afternoon, I think. But let's see what happens. It's very strange and not at all dramatic, and suddenly very cool. Cool.
This is what he would have heard, what the prince would have heard. 1, 2, 3 first violins, 2 second violins, 1 viola, 1 cello, 1 bass. No wind in this movement.
The recording, the only recording I have of this piece, that movement, I'll just show how it goes. Let's play it. Pretty grim after the first half hour. 1, 2, 3. Stop. It goes on like that forever. They don't do the second repeat, thank goodness. It is grim. But I mean, those are the things that are interesting.
Have you ever preferred using a baton, or has it always been very...
Oh, no, I use a baton for large-scale music, yes.
Mahler or something like that?
Mahler, Bruckner, Tchaikovsky, Dvořák, Beethoven 9, Rizzo's Lemnis, yeah. It's only that it gets in the way with this kind of music, funnily enough, but it does absolutely nothing. Never trust a conductor who conducts Baroque or classical music with a baton. He means he probably doesn't know anything about it.
I'll remember that.
Remember that.